What's wrong with being right? What's wrong with being right? What's wrong with being right? Is the thought of no thought, is that any closer to no thought? Is the thought of no thought any closer to no thought? Is it closer than the thought of thoughts? Thought of no thought. Consider that, consider that. Welcome to the video. Welcome to the taping. Got through the previous insights of the previous day. Everything's fine. Experienced a little bit of the white light, of the fresh light, light as freshness, instead of pretending to be determinant. But then it sort of faded out because I went back to determinacy. Of course, it has to respond to our requests, how we want it to appear. So is the thought of no thoughts, I have a concept of no thoughts, is that closer to no thought, or is it the same? This is a question. So the practice of meditation, the mind keeps bringing up thoughts and concepts of no concepts and no thought. And you have to keep saying no to that, no to that. It's like bringing up an image of enlightenment, an image of realization, a thought of realization. Say no, 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 that's not it, drop it. No, that's not it, drop it. How about the thought of dropping all thoughts? Is that something we need to hold on to? Or do we need to drop the thought of dropping all thoughts too? Drop that. We don't need thoughts to be, and drop that thought too. So this discipline gets quite intense very quickly, doesn't it? When we say drop all thoughts, what happens is we hang on to the thought of dropping all thoughts and say, okay, and then wonder, how come I'm not feeling any better? Nothing happened. Well, is the thought of dropping all thoughts, is that the answer? Or is that just another thought? I think it was last night, I suddenly flipped the script just for a moment, like that, just that quick. I said, wow, I just did it. And then I got distracted and somehow I couldn't remember what happened. But instead of struggling with it, I just said, okay, I'm experiencing a continuity fear right now. That's all. So don't try to remember what happened. Don't struggle with it. Just full stop in the now of this wow. We'll stop on the now of wow. I just flipped the script. So I'm still working through that because it's tough to be patient when you just flip the whole script. Just flip the whole script. And then suddenly got distracted from this. You want to get frustrated, but you have to say, no, what happened? Well, continuity fear immediately kicked in. So what you need to do is praise the whole situation. Say, great, continuity fear, that's great. You kicked in just like I told you you're supposed to do. But now we're following a slightly different program in that you're not going to kick in so strongly next time, okay? and so that's great. So in other words, the goal was reached for a moment. The goal was reached for a moment. And 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 it's important, don't try to remember. It's a very difficult discipline, so this is a real tough time. But not too tough. But the tendency is to struggle and gasp, to try to get back to that, try to remember what happened, what was the flip. It's so very simple, very simple. Very obvious, very simple. I'm sure I can do it again, no problem at all. I just don't recall what I did. Because the continuity fear jumped up and said, okay, hit the brakes real fast, because the flip was so quick. It's like, I did it. And then it's like, whoa, I did it, but hit the brake. So what's important is to experience knowing that I did it, and then how do I feel about that? And to prove to myself that I can remain, meek, humble, unassuming, calm, poised, patient, not freaked out. So I'm probably just evaluating myself right now, evaluating the situation. It's kind of like, let's say you have all these Christmas lights you put up, an amazing display of Christmas lights, and you turn it on for a second after you've done all the wiring and everything. You turn it on and pow, it all goes on all at the same time, and you got this stupendous display of sparkling lights and everything, and then you just go, oh my gosh, what will the neighbors think? Poof, you turn it off again, like that. it's like, oh my gosh, I don't know. Very much like that. So nothing succeeds like familiarity. But taking no thought also means don't try to figure out how you're going to function with this. How are you going to help others? Give no thought to that either. That immediately tends to pull me away from it. So a good way to imagine the continuity scenario is, again, let's say you have a big, huge pine tree in your yard, evergreen type of conifer in your yard, and looks like a huge Christmas tree. And so you put up a couple hundred thousand lights on it. Every branch, trunk, every branch, every leaf is just covered with this incredible amount of work you've done. Worked for years streaming this tree up. And then you plug the power in and at night, and just the whole street, the whole neighborhood is just lit up with this stunningly beautiful display of light. And again, you say, oh boy, I think maybe that's too much. And you click, you just have a switch there, you turn the switch off. It's that quick. It's like that. It's just a little switch. I just turned the switch and it flipped. I said, whoa, that's easy. That's too easy. That's too easy. Now, if we're afraid of turning on that Christmas tree light, the lights on the Christmas tree, We're going to become unaware that there's just this easy switch to do it. And we'll say, how do I turn this on? I'm trying to, but I can't figure it out. It'll go like that. And we'll be greatly confused and deceived. The truth is, we're afraid to turn it on because we think it's too much. So we're unaware that we have this switch. So the first step here we're looking at is to be aware that we have this switch. So I would be focusing on that more than anything else. And full stop with this recognition, like, wow, I just have this simple switch. It's that simple. Yeah, that feels a very, very great, very great focus. So let's look at this. Let's keep looking at this. Very important. Again, there's a plug in the wall. Electrical plugged into electricity. You have this huge tree that is stupendously covered with the most gorgeous lighting decorations anyone's ever seen. And in your hand, with electrical cord, there's the in line of that cord, there's just a simple switch, on-off toggle switch. And so you decide, let me see, push the switch, click, the whole tree lights up instantly. And then you say, whoops, that might be too much. Click, turn it off. Okay. Then you start thinking. Let's talk about what we are used to doing. We start thinking, okay, you get kind of panicky, and then what happens, what comes in is sort of this defense mechanism. And you forget that there is a switch, and you say, I'm working, and then you start thinking, you know, I'm working so hard on getting that tree lit up and in. I still can't figure out how to get it lit up. It's crazy. What's wrong with God? What's wrong with the Holy Spirit? They're not helping me out. I can't seem to get this tree lit. And you'll start reading books, talking to people, going to seminars. How come I can't get this tree lit? You know, it's the weirdest thing. So difficult. I just can't figure it out. It must be something wrong with the wiring. I'm trying to check the connections and all the strands of lights. I just can't seem to get it on. I can't get the light to go on. And so you're really down and frustrated. Okay, this is what we're used to. But what we're going to do here is to shift and say, no, that's not the problem. Everything's perfect. Everything's fine. My problem is the continuity problem. My problem is that it's the tree is too brilliant. It's so brilliantly beautiful. I'm afraid that it's too much. And then to recognize I have a continuity problem. And the problem is not turning the tree on because I have the switch right here in my hand. And so recognize we have the switch. Recognize you have the switch and just work on accepting that. That's not the problem. See, the switch is not the problem. Turning it on is not the problem at all. Everything's good to go. It's just I'm afraid of turning it on. It's too bright. So say, yes, I do have the switch. Yes, I do have an easy switch. It's not difficult. It's simple. Totally easy. I can do it at any instant I want to. I'm just choosing not to. Nothing is wrong. I'm just choosing not to out of continuity fear. So long saying, I can't get my light to go on. I'll never be able to get it going. I just can't figure it out. What's wrong? And so what I'm saying here is this continuity practice it resolves this. Is to say, I don't have a tree lighting problem at all. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an electrical problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a wiring problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a can't turn the tree on problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a depression problem. I have a continuity problem. Everything's fine. The wiring's fine. The tree's fine. The lighting's fine. Everything's fine. The switch is there. I'm just afraid to hit the switch because the tree will be so beautiful. Think otherwise, we will overlook what the facts and struggle. So a lot of people are going over the schematics of the tree, the wiring of the schematics. Spending a lot of time on the schematics. And there's nothing wrong with the schematics. There's nothing that needs to be changed. Overlooking the fact they have the switch in their hands. Totally overlooking this fact. Because they say, it can't be that simple. I'm way smarter than that. I never would have missed that. That's ridiculous. See, the continuity problem makes fools of us all. And this is what's called repentance. Mood of repentance is to realize you've just been making a fool out of yourself the whole time. The continuity fear has made a fool out of us. Where we have not been searching in the right place. Searching for answers. Where the answer's right in our hand. The switch is right there. Very simple to hit that switch. Or you know, another way to say it, you have a plug in your hand and all you have to do is just plug it in. That's easy. And you're spending all this time studying the schematics, adjusting the schematics, saying, wait, maybe I adjust this light a little bit this way and this one that way. So the flip was just like that, it was that quick. The script was just flipped, like turning a switch on. And I said, aha, is that my response? I said, aha, oh, okay. I was so stunned by it, I forgot. I sort of, it was so stunning. How easy it was, how quick and easy, and just it was that simple. I was just stunned by it. So now it's all about just sitting, the discipline of sitting quietly. Full stop in the now of this wow. I don't think that's an easy discipline. This is what trips us up. We all get tripped up. You know, it's like I just had all my problems answered, and now I forgot what the answer was. So what do? You jump off a bridge or something? No. Oh, my only problems are now and they're still, you know, you just have to keep your poise. It's like you have all this money in the bank and the ATM and you forgot your password and you're starving. You need the money, you got to pay bills and it's terrible and you're working on the password. And finally, boom, there it is, you got it. And you go, wow. I got it or something, and you're celebrating. It's like, wow, it's great. Then it times out or something. It times out. You know, just please enter your password again. You've timed out. Say, okay. You say, okay. And they'd say, whoa, draw a blank. I forgot it. And just draw a complete blank. last night before evening prayer, before dinner prayer, I said, okay, I'm going to say the prayer. And my mind went completely blank. I couldn't think what the prayer was. I couldn't remember what it is I'd been working on all day. Just complete blank. And so I waited. Still blank. I said, wow. So instead of struggling, I just said, okay, let's just full stop in this blank. The wow of this blank. So I had to stop. I said, okay, give me a little moment here. And then after a little while, oh, it came back. I said, oh yeah. One dreamer, dreaming one dream of many dreamers, dreaming of many dreamers, dreaming of many dreamers, dreaming of many dreamers. This is what the situation is. But for a while there, for I'd say about, a couple minutes, 2 or 3 minutes or more, I was just blank. I drew a complete blank. How could I draw a blank on what is so important? I was spending all day practicing on it, and I just drew a blank. Pretty amazing. Too advanced, so I ended up not saying that in the prayer. I didn't say it once I remembered it. So maybe that when this light, the tree lights up, we say, we're worried that this, you know, how are we going to, you know, show this to everybody? Well, I'll say, well, maybe we won't need to show it to everybody. You know, it's not necessary. Maybe just the people, let the Holy Spirit, let the people drive past. Whoever wants to see it will see it. Let the Holy Spirit be in charge of that. I'm not going to try and aggressively market it. Let the Holy Spirit take care of the marketing of the tree. So, I drew this blank after I flipped the script and realized that my problems haven't been solved. I don't have any problems. And I drew a blank on it. Blanked out. So this will happen. If you think that you need to share it with those who have no idea what you're talking about, you may. In other words, just draw a blank when you talk to them. It's like talking to a wall. Just draw a blank. And maybe you'll feel this blank downness and say, wow, that's too much. So, but even walls have ears. So when you try to struggle in a memory, you start throwing a bunch of thoughts, and then those thoughts have thoughts, and you develop a whirlwind, a hurricane of thoughts, and that's real bad. And then so don't develop any thoughts at all about it. Don't let any, just whatever thoughts arise, just drop them. It's like a breeze, just drop the breeze. And so there's nothing, no storm arises, no storm of reaction. It's true that people can get this, and then afterwards they'll draw a blank, and they completely forget. Like right now, I've apparently completely forgotten what it is, which is amazing. But still, this is what happens. So I just have to bear with this. Problem is that the ego can come back at this point and say, "Hey, you know." It's not right. If you really forgot it, you're so smart, you really forgot it, it couldn't have been that important. You know, let's grab hold of what we know, and then the ego could reassert itself under these conditions. That's why it's so important to talk about the continuity fear. And I only have one problem with this, but it's a very severe problem. So the ego will not reassert itself. You see, this is the key. Jump in and say, no ego. This was legit, 100% legit. I know the truth. It's not far away. It's not buried. It's just right here. I have a continuity problem that is causing me to waver a little bit. That's all. So I'm not going to struggle with it, not get upset. Not fall back on some sort of structure. Problem has evaporated a little bit more, it will come back, it will flip again. So You don't try to force it. See, trying to force it, then you start thinking, well, how come I can't get this going? Let me go back and think about all the other stuff I was thinking about. And there you go, into the ego, into the belief in the past, all of that. So you must simply keep your mind, drop the thoughts that arise, keep dropping them. Drop the reactions, wherever they are, you are in this concatenation of reactions, thoughts, stories. Just drop it right in the middle, wherever you are, just let it go, let go of it. It's like you have a ball in your hand and you want to see how high you can bounce, so you're climbing this ladder. And just say, oh, stop. Stop climbing the ladder. You know, and we say, but I won't be able to know how high the ball can bounce unless I climb up to the top of the ladder as an experiment. No, just drop it. You'll never know how high the ball can bounce. Just drop it. Doesn't matter. Drop the experiments. Drop the story about how this turns out, or might turn out. Don't anticipate anything. So believe it or not, this is how to go really fast. Just go really slow. Drop the thoughts of going fast. Drop all thoughts of going fast. So to go fast, drop all thoughts of going fast. Okay? Drop all thoughts. To be successful, drop all thoughts of being successful. Drop all this thinking of success. To be peaceful, drop all thoughts of being peaceful. Gotta go up in the mountains today, it's raining. It's going to be very heavy, heavy weather. High up in the mountains. And a storm. Drop that thought too. Thoughts of failure, drop all thoughts of success. So obviously, if I was able to flip the script, I must be doing something right. And it was very easy and simple, and so I must be close. So no reason to panic and think that I lost my opportunity, or all is lost. Drop that. No need to panic. Now the fact that it went blank so quickly is just a continuity problem. Doesn't reflect upon the success of flipping the script at all. Just means I sort of reversed direction real quickly. Is the thought of no thought, is that no thought? don't go back to the event and say, how did the event feel? How did I almost had it? How did it, what was that like? Because right now, we're in this continuity reaction, so stay with the continuity reaction. That's what succeeds. Always stay with the continuity reaction once something is triggered like this. As I said, normalize. Normalize this, what we're normalizing here. So what we're going to do is we're going to normalize having the switch in our hand. We're not going to try and flip the switch, okay? We're going to normalize having in our hand without switching it. And so our thoughts, our consideration, our attention, let's say our attention is, hey, I have the switch right in my hand. And that's it. We're not going any further than that. We're not turning the light on. We're saying, my gosh, I have the switch right in my hand. And get used to that first. And feel good about it. And feel normal about it. So we've taken this leap and we turned it into two nice little steps. First one is just get used to, maybe several steps right now is just get used to having the switch. Oh, I have a switch in my hand and that's it. I have the switch right here. I can see it. It's with me. And just focus on that, focus on that. Changed the whole mood here. Just suddenly, the whole mood just shifted for me. It's like, hey, this is great. Instead of being all downcast, it's I failed. Now I feel like, wonderful. I have this switch. I'm not going to turn it on right now because I'm getting used to the switch. So in the sense of just saying, I'm not going to be enlightened right now. I'm choosing not to. See how powerful that is? Because that's putting it into the realm of choice. Instead of something you're struggling for, that you're trying to get it or something. And now he's like, no, I choose not to be enlightened right now. I'm choosing not to be enlightened. I'm choosing not to throw the switch. How about that? Get used to that first. Get used to that first. Choosing not to be enlightened today. Hi, you meet somebody. Hi, how are you? Ah, oh, man, I'm choosing not to be enlightened today. And I feel great about that. I've decided today I'm not going, right now I'm not going to be enlightened. Yeah. I'm choosing to feel miserable today, unenlightened and miserable today. And that's great. Put it in the realm of your choice, you see. So this is a secret of practicing now. The way to reach the goal is first recognize you're choosing not to reach it. And celebrate that. Be happy with that, so to speak. It produces a different perspective. Hey, I'm choosing not to turn on the tree. Choosing not to switch on the tree. How are you? Yeah, I'm here with the switch and I'm choosing not to switch on the tree. Okay, that's great. and then feel really grounded with this, because it's, you're realizing it's your choice, you're choosing this. Maybe this isn't flipping the script, right? I'm not choosing not to recognize truth today, right now. I'm choosing not to recognize I am. Today I'm choosing not to be enlightened. Right now, I'm choosing not to be enlightened. I'm making a conscious choice. I'm not going to turn on this switch. Conscious, you're bringing it into consciousness first through this negation, because that's what's really happening. We're choosing not to be enlightened right now. So be conscious of it. Bring that through into consciousness first, because you have to. You have to be conscious of what you're doing right now, right? Otherwise, you'll feel dissociated. And so, you know, right now, I'm making this strong choice to not be enlightened, to not turn that switch on, not flip that switch. Great. That's empowerment, empowering, isn't it? Because you're aware of what you're choosing, power of choice. And you say, look at the tremendous power of choice I have. The whole world looks unenlightened to me. Everything. Misery, suffering, death. I'm choosing this right this moment. I could flick a switch and it all change. All problems have vanished. But I'm choosing to see all these problems and time, and space, and process, and form, and sickness, and death, and fear, and depression, and suffering, and vulnerability, and hatred, and conflict, and all this. I say, yeah, I'm choosing to be unenlightened right now. And what a tremendous effect it has. That's a wow right there, isn't it? And this returns us to spiritual dignity, to saying, hey, I have the power. And I'm exercising this power right now, and look at the effects of this power that I'm exercising. It's an incredible effect, isn't it? It's like I switched off all the light everywhere. I hit the switch and all the light is off. So own that, own it. You see, say, wow, look what I did, look at the power I have. This is the switch, I have a switch in my hand, and I turned it off, and all these problems appear. Isn't that amazing? Power of the switch, power of choice. So we might be dancing and celebrating, but why do you feel so? I feel great then. Well, I realize that the power of choice that I have, I'm choosing to turn things, make it seem like all the lights are off, all the light is gone, the light has turned itself off. And I'm experiencing my power right now, power of spirit, to see all this as if all the light is no longer the light. Just by a switch, just a simple request, boom. Wow, the whole universe responds to my simple request. Simple request, and I feel like I'm not in control of how I feel or what I'm experiencing or anything. Wow, what a weird trip. See, just a simple request, click, switch, and this totally weird trip arises. This complete scenario of total weirdness arises. Wow, Tremendous power of spirit, huh? So when we say we're already enlightened, don't worry about enlightenment. This is true. What we need to recognize is our power. And our power is how it's being expressed right now. So by not owning the fact that this is an expression of our power, this whole dreamlike scenario, we feel disempowered. And so we're searching for empowerment within this dream, waiting for it to somehow come to us through the dynamics of nature and all this stuff, instead of realizing this is our power. This is an expression of our power. We asked the light to pretend to be dead. And it played this, playing dead for us. The entire universe is playing dead. Just a simple request from us is all it takes. And so by recognizing this, we start to remember our power and recognize we do have the power. So we're spirit. As Jesus says, the entire universe is at our bidding. More than that, the light itself is. The light itself is. That's our bidding. That's what we are, Son of God. Co-creators with God. And so it's done our bidding by presenting this completely bizarre and weird scenario of the light being non-responsive to us. And recognizing this apparent non-responsiveness of light, that is an expression of our power. How powerful we are, we can even have light pretend that it's not light. Simple request, and that's what it does. Fantastic. Fantastic. <Yes. laughs> So no one's lost their power. No one's lost their power. Playing a game of losing their power, as if light does no longer respond to them. And instead, light has decided to do its own thing. And its own thing is this nature and this universe, and that we are simply now living in this new reality of where light is off on its own agenda, has a separate agenda from us. This is the belief that we've been playing. It is realized it is not off on a separate agenda at all. It's doing exactly what we asked it to do. So we haven't lost our power at all. So these happy days are here again. See that with this, everything looks exactly the same. The world hasn't lit up or been transformed. No, it's exactly, it's all miserable, rotting hell, you know, but the attitude, perspective is all shifted. See how this is great. This just shows what incredible power I have. Tremendous power, all power, look at that. Look at this. As we recover the belief that we not the belief, that the reality, the fact that we have all this power, then we'll start saying, you know what? I'm going to start exercising this power. You know? So maybe I don't, you know, maybe I'm tired of this scenario of death and darkness and all that stuff. Flip of a switch, it's all lit up again, see, like that. So the first step is to recognize your power, the power we have. We've never lost it. We've never lost it. Not even for an instant. The power of misery. That's what we really need to recognize first, actually. Forget about now. Forget about the power of now. Focus on the power of misery. That's a reflection of anything ever was of our power. Absolutely. We're so powerful, we can pretend to not be powerful. If we can flick a switch and this all disappears, I mean, all suddenly just no problems at all, and then we flick it back and the problems are there, we must be the ones who are doing this, right? We have the power over what it is we experience. We have the power. These bodies die, and so they no longer serve us, as if the light has died completely and is no longer even responsive to us at all. Right? We tell the body move, we say, well, the body's still responding. Oh, but now the body's dead, it's not responding. Oh, the light has completely severed its connection with spirit, and it's now completely separate. What power we have to get light to do this, getting light to jump through these hoops. And it's just doing so effortlessly, you know? Wow. If we're confused about this, we'll be afraid to flip that switch because they say, well, you know, what happened to my power? Confused about your power. But if you recognize that this too is showing your power, equal to anything else. Then it's not a matter of gaining or losing power. If you think you suddenly gained power, you'll freak out. So if you flip a switch and the whole world's a light and no problems, you say, oh my gosh, I just regained all my power. Then you'll freak out. Why? Because you say, wait a minute, I just regained my power. How did I lose it? And then, you know, you go back and say, wait a minute, I got to figure out how I lost this. Because I could lose it again. So first, recognize the power right here, right now. So that when you flip the switch, you realize you're just deciding to change your experiencing, but it's not a change in your power at all. You're not empowering yourself at all. The nature of reality, then, is pure potential. There's no such thing as powered on or powered off. It's always on. Mm. This is a wow. This is a wow, for sure. It's important again, full stop in the now of this wow. Without trying to link it too much with what anyone else is saying, because this is our own experiencing, right? It's more important when we're experiencing to realize, hey, this is my experiencing of the power of spirit that I am. It's here right now for me. It's not in some book. It's not in what I heard someone say. It's here right here now. So, sure, others have talked about this. Sure, don't try to think of who said this or is it. That's not staying in the now of this wow. Full stop in the now of this wow. Don't say, how did I get here? No getting here. It's realization of power is always here. Power's always on. Don't go grabbing for any crutches. Just try to keep your balance right where you are. If things start swaying, you immediately grab for the safety crutches, safety bar. Oh, okay, holding on to that. But what we want to do is put all our will into, see if we can maintain our balance and maintain our stability as this whole landscape is shifting. Put all our will and efforts out. We will not grab hold of any crutch. I will not. Will not. Because those crutches are conceptuality and a chain of conceptuality that seems to be stable. But that's being unaware of your true power, okay? A substitute, fake power. That's not what your power is. Power is that you are requesting this instability and it's here. That's the shows your power. It's like, wow, I'm so powerful, I can even feel that my power is unstable. What incredible power, what amazing power it is. This is the don't struggle with the struggle. Instead, celebrate and say, hey, this just shows my power, really. We come into this world, we're trying to be more powerful by being confused, everything. We think we're gaining some greater power than God gave us. And we fail to realize, we already have all power. And so then we end up getting confused and trapped and stuck, and this is what happens. You see kids coming into this world, you ask them, why are you dumbing yourself down, getting confused? Well, it's fun. I want to do it. This is fun. It's fun to lose my power. I want to know what it feels like to lose my power. And the answer is you can't lose your power. But you can play the game as if you have lost it. You feel like a lost soul. There are no lost souls. There's only spirits pretending to be a lost spirit. You know, I've lost all my power. I've been disempowered. Disempowerment is a display of your power. Told that. I'm going to be very careful here. Can I just hold on a second? Yeah. Keep staying in the now. The full stop in the now of the wow. In the now of the wow. Full stop in the now of the wow. was going to reference something very profound, but it's more important to stay in the full stop and now, wow, that's even more important. Because this is where the power is. Right now is where the power is. Maybe that's, yeah, well, again, drop that. Drop that. Drop the reference. Because we have a feeling right now of, wow, that's what's important. It's like, wow, I really am powerful. Wow, I really have figured it out. So stay with the feeling, even though the feeling is staggered, shocked, stunned by the great good news and fortune you have. A great good fortune. I recall dreaming back in 1978, 79-ish. And this massive pile of gold was poured out upon this, where I was sitting on the deck of this big ship. Steam shovels dumped this huge pile. I was just pure shining gold. And I was just so stunned by this, so staggered and stunned. So good fortune can stagger and stun us to an extraordinary extent. So the realization, hey, I never lost my power at all. That's really good news, isn't it? It's very stunning, very staggering. So stay with that stunness and give that your attention. There comes a little bit of rain. Spiritual shock was not a good thing. It's defense. It's a defense. We can use about 6 months of this room. Choosing the power is always on, so the power is going into being without power. We're powering up, we're empowering disempowering, is what we're doing. And yet the power is still completely there, just being put into disempower. There's 100% power, always, always is in reality. Total, pure, perfect potentiality is never exhausted or tired or diminished at all. Disempowerment. And just look at that. Yeah, I've done a great job putting the power into disempowerment. Terrific. Tremendous power involved in this. So it's not so much the tree not being on or off. Being off is empowerment. Being on is empowerment. It's all empowerment. I never be disempowered. So you can say I'm powering up the non-light of the tree, or now I'm powering up the light of the tree, and now I'm disempowering the light of the tree. Right? But the power to disempower is the same power to empower. It's like light and darkness are the same power. I'm choosing to power up light. And I'm choosing to power up darkness, or lack of light. Remember, the real light is the clear light. So when we empower up visible light, so to speak, it's the same as empowering up no light. It's all the same, the clear light. You could say that you say, well, with the light, the tree being on, that's a condition that I asked for. And now I flip the switch and power goes on. See, wow, what a power I have to turn all those lights off. Now let's say you're somebody who's at the central power of a city, great city, and there's a switch. And you throw the switch and all the lights in the city go on. Millions of lights. Boom. And then you pull the switch, you pull the switch the other way. All the lights in the city go off. And don't you feel like an equal sense of power? It's just like, wow. I can turn all the lights off. Just like that. Yeah, and so it's like, it's just like that. Which is the empowering state? Both. It doesn't have to be one conquering the other. There's no conquering into your potential. All potential always remains, always present. There's no triumph. Look at the victim saying, look at how much power I have. I was able to die at your hands. I empowered my death at your hands. I have more power than you do. You know, the victim is the one who's saying, I have more power than you do. Look at this. I have so much power, I can disempower myself, even to the point of death. Whereas you're still living. So you haven't been able to disempower yourself as much as I have. this is what's going on here in this one, this situation. But as soon as you start playing the game of more power, you're playing the game of less power. You see, automatically. And you don't realize it. This is called duality. And then you're afraid to say, well, I can't stop dying, I have less power. If I have less power, someone's going to conquer me and enslave me. I can't have less power. I gotta keep dying here. I gotta keep dying. So as long as we think this world is an expression of more power, then we're trapped in it. Because we certainly don't want less. Because then we're afraid of more. So we keep on dying and keep on this with this experience of apparent disempowerment, using our power to give an experience of disempowerment and believing that this shows that we're more powerful than any power. More powerful than God, even. We've caused power to not be powerful, you know, what they're saying. And try to give it up. Whoops! I want less power. So, this is the trap. This is the trap. It's all a mental trap. You just have to see. This doesn't mean more power. Having less power doesn't mean more. There is no down. There is no down. There is no less. There is no down. Where I am, there is no down. Pure potential. So what we're doing here is we're just getting normalizing, just getting used to where we're at. So we keep looking at it from different angles, slightly different expressions, all just chit-chat, like talking about the weather. Oh yeah, I'm used to where I am. This is where I live. I live in this understanding, this recognition. This is my home. This is my territory. This is where I'm at. It's like you're camping on a camping trip. You're going around the country, you park your RV somewhere, you say, you stop this lake, and you say, I'm going to stay here for a while. And you stay there for maybe a week, and by that time you feel very comfortable, like, oh, this is home. This feels like home to me. Oh, there's the birds that come in the morning, and there's the raccoon that comes in for our food, and here's the squirrels, and here's, you know, the weather like this, and here's the people, and it, you know, everything. You say, oh, this is, I'm used to this now. And then you get up and you go to the next campsite. This is what campers, RVers are doing, right? Moving their comfort zone, I feel. So that's what we're doing, just camping out here. We're camping out with this, and just camping out, feeling like, this is normal. The attitude of a camper. We're not in a big hurry. Just kind of, but this is all new to us, guys. Pretty new. There's some different trees here. Everything's familiar, but also a little bit different now. Words don't come so easily. That's because of the shock of them. if we're experiencing something that we don't like, we say we don't like, it's actually our attempt to empower ourselves, have greater power than all power, greater power than God. That's why. But ultimately, it's because of the continuity fear. Because we really are tired of this, and we want to drop it, but we feel we can't. We're afraid we'll have less power. There's this continuity fear. We're afraid. We're afraid of recognizing our power. We've been thinking that having less is a possibility. See, because we're trying to have more, we feel that less is definitely in play. And now we suddenly realize there is no such thing as less. There is no down where I am. There is no less. There is no down where I am. There is no less. And this is a shock. Good news is a shock. Absolute shock. Wow. It means I'm not trapped by this world, right? I'm not trapped by death. At all. I'm not trapped by anything. I was just in this continuity trap of less and more. And suddenly the recognition there is no less has come. Oh, then it's all perfect. And I'm not trapped at all. You know, it's, wow, so it's almost, it's overwhelming. And some, you know, somebody's just like, well, the news is just too good to be true, but it is true. So, it's like we're in the land of 1,000 lakes, or 10,000 was Minnesota, the land of 10,000 lakes or something. And we go to one lake, camp, and then we go to the next lake. And each lake is a little more beautiful. Each lake we go to, the scenery is even more beautiful. And gradually we realize, wow, I've been going, getting better and better and better for me. And then you come back to your mind and say, you know what, it seems like the next lake is going to be just fantastic one. And after that, even better. And it's like, wow, just keep going to these lakes, keep camping. And just enjoy where you are, get used to it. Because then this will enable you to go to the next one, which is even more beautiful. The news is even better. So what we're doing is we're actually experiencing a good news cycle, all right? Whereas the world is experiencing a bad news cycle, always. We're actually living a good news cycle. I'm sort of a reporter reporting the good news to the world, to everyone. Hey, this is the good news. I'm in a good news cycle, actually. It gets better and better and better, the news. Keep in mind that this news is so great, it's staggering. It'll stagger you for a day until you sort of catch, you know, it takes you a while to regain your equilibrium a little bit. Just because we stopped the video doesn't mean, oh, you know, you're not still in shock a little bit. Absolutely. You need to keep this in mind. It's like a very strenuous workout. Well, after you stop, you feel better, right? But the effects are still lingering on during the day and into the next day. All right. So keep this in mind. See how the rest of the day goes. But just enjoy the campsite. Hey, this stop because I have to go do other stuff. This is better than doing other stuff. Better than doing other stuff for sure. Okay, so in doing other stuff and forgetting, say, hey, this forgetting is an empowerment. What a tremendous display of my power is that I've forgotten. What a tremendous display of my power. And right then, you've remembered. And that's it.